Barista competitions are the face that specialty coffee has to offer as to the high end of what we're doing and sort of a unified front. It's a chance for us to say to the media, hey, look at this, look at what we pay attention to, what's important to us, how legitimate we are. Part Olympics, part dog show, part personal crisis.
Now this is espresso and carbonated strawberries, which I've supercharged with CO2 in a whipper. Now as they sit in the espresso, these strawberries release tiny CO2 bubbles. Imagine soda going flat, filling the espresso with strawberry aromatics.
Barista competitions are a sport. You go out, you have a good day, you win. You go out, you have a bad day, you lose. When you compete, you're going up against people that this is their focus in life.
Our champion's already ready to give it another try for 2013, so I'm not going to waste any time. Katie Cargiulo from Counterculture Coffee, Brooklyn, New York.
Thanks, Carrie. Thanks, Carrie.
A great cup of coffee for coffee people is really complex, but I want to be able to explain it to people so that they can start to dig their heels in a little bit and understand what makes coffee what it is. I want to just make tasty things for people, and I want them to be happy, and I want them to enjoy it, but I want to be able to communicate a little bit on a deeper level sort of what makes the coffee that I'm making so different and so much more special than any other coffee that they drink.
Coffee gets made three times. It's first made at the farm when cherries are harvested and then they're processed and dried to become beans. It is next made at the roastery, where beans go from green to brown. And roasters use their machines to balance out the flavors in the coffee with flavors that are created by the roast. And the last time it gets made is when it's made into a beverage. And this kind of gets all the credit because this is what people see. They see it in their own homes, they see it in cafes, and on special days, they see it on barista competition stages. So any day that you drink a coffee, these are the three acts of its story. So as a customer, your experience of a beverage is not just limited to the flavor. And that's really what I like about cappuccinos is that they're very pretty and they're served with a visual representation of the skill of the people that make them in the form of a little heart or a delicate flower, which is in and of itself a visual representation of all things romantic. And that's sort of how I feel about cappuccinos, and it's what I like about being a barista, is that we are the people that get to romance people into the world of specialty coffee. I hope you've enjoyed your experience today. Thank you so much for being here. Time.
Time. Come on back, champ. Ladies and gentlemen, Katie Cargiulo, Counterculture.